Hi friends, long time no talk. How are y'all doing? How is everything going? It's a little bit late. I haven't had the time to film in a minute and I still wanted to post this soon, this weekend. Trying my best. So I have here some mental comfort and I'm sorry if I look tired and stuff, it's because I am. Today is very exciting. Today I'm going to be showing you how I organize my digital space. As you're going to see in a bit, my computer is definitely the workspace that I use for like everything, and you see me a lot going through my computer in a lot of vlogs. I feel like it's the most organized it's gonna get. I feel like this is the ultimate state that my digital space is ever going to look like. It's going to be like this. So I have a few things to show y'all that I thought would be helpful. So let's just get into it and I hope you enjoy. Okay, so for this first part, my computer is not letting me record. So just stay with me. So these are all my resources. I have a folder. I should really put this in the hard drive because I'm really scared to lose this. The computer will eventually die off. All of my technology will eventually die off. I don't make the rules. These are all my resources that I have. I download files. These right here, I don't really know. I don't remember why I saved these. But yeah, just ignores these documents that I put here. For the first and the second year, I didn't exactly save a lot of things. Now on my fourth year, I keep like everything. For example, this is a pretty big subject, and so I had to make extra folders for each particular specialty. I also make a particular folder for question bank. And eventually, if the semester is really crazy like this one, I don't even bother to organize like so many documents. If I want to study a lecture, I can just go here. If I want to do question bank, this way it's like pretty easy for me to find pretty much anything in here that I've studied. I really recommend you to do this earlier on. I don't really need the resources of my first, second year, but I think from the third year forward, I might need some textbooks and stuff like that. But really, just for the sake of keeping things organized and you have your resources from the very start is really important. This video is sponsored by Idenati, but I've been using this every single day. I'm very flattered that they sponsored me again. It's because of y'all that they decided to reach out to me again. But before I explain everything, so Idenati is basically a command center for everything that you do online. I have it bookmarked, and so when I first open Google Chrome, everything's bookmarked and saved for each particular thing that you want to do online. And so everything that you do online can be here. So for example, if I want to go to my school email, it takes me directly to my school email. If I want to go to the Moodle platform or any page inside the Moodle, I can go here and I use this like every single day. It's the first thing I see. It helps you kind of direct your thought. You don't have to have 1,000 tabs open. If you don't want to see a particular page in a website, if you just want to go to that particular page and skip all the little steps in between, these are the tiles that I click to get to things. You can also search through keywords. So for example, I'm searching Chloe and I've written here on the tile like Chloe as a note, and through these categories. First thing is entertainment, and I have basically my K-dramas that I'm watching right now. Also Twitch, Two Set, which is like a YouTube channel, another K-drama, and actually the Wuthering Heights audiobook. Online courses, so you have Skillshare, music theory class, and African American class. Next for self-care, we have exercise thing and ASMR ambience. This is a link to the Google search for ASMR ambience. We have shopping, book sales, a book wish list. Let me show y'all my book wish list. Oh my God, stop it. They're all on sale. What do you mean? I can't look at this. Okay. Next we have uni. I bookmark all of the links to the specifics. Oh, this is not well written. OBGYN. Specific links to the subject. A YouTube live stream for a seminar that I want to catch. So the link for library reservation, Google Calendar, Facebook classes that I want to check later so I don't have to look for anything. Emboss, this is like a really nice low-file video that I like currently. And then my most used ones, so regular Moodle, the most important subject of the semester, my notes, I will go into my notes, and I will go into my Notion, and my school email. The last section, which is YouTube, where I have a link to my YouTube studio, to my channel comments, Epidemic Sound, which is like where I get my music. This is, y'all, this is like for the Skillshare sponsorships, Patreon, royalty-free music, more stuff for Patreon. Oh my god, I don't need this anymore. For this baby that arrived. Okay, she was hard to get here. So that's all the tiles that I have. So let's get into the notes and lists, which is also like one of my favorite things to do here. So like I said, so this is what I had to do today. Did I do all of this? No. So basically, I have three sections each day. I'm going to do Thursday with y'all. I normally try to keep it at three tasks per section. I didn't finish this lecture, but I'll try to finish it. That's basically what I try to do. Like, I try to set three tasks or less each section, and then I write next one. So it stays here, but this is like the next day, and I can just like copy paste tasks that didn't get done. Like my the Moodle and the notes, the bullet journal, it's where I did it. Okay, here I need Patreon. And the forms. And then I have two extra lists. So I have K-dramas to watch, and then sponsored videos where I have this one and Skillshare next. So let's head on to Notion to write lists and make things more organized. So this is a pretty cover for everything that I have in here. Nice quotes and pretty pictures and just good things to look at. And these are more specific links to inside the academia section. This is a very simple gallery where I put all the K-dramas that I've watched or am watching, and I rank them. All the templates that I have, I will link on the description box of this video. This was a template that I got from Yura's channel. You put the picture here that you want to show, and you choose a genre, and you rate it. I'm watching these two at the moment, like I'm on the last few episodes. These are so good. Like, I've already given the ratings because they're so freaking good. Really excited to have a long list of this. Next we have my Patreon timeline. Really nice because it's perfect for my Patreon, because I forget things so easily, and so I really need to stay on track. For example, let me put here the May printable. Why did I put April podcast here? It's not what it's called. May podcast. Here on this weekend. And you can see you can drag it around and change the order of it. So it's just really useful. Next, we have my wish list. I put several columns on. This is also a pretty, like, just, it's just one widget. I basically put several columns through different price tags. I put category for YouTube, and then tracking if I need to tracking. Like, for example, it's to be shipped and the keyboard is shipped, so it's kind of like tracking things at a glance and kind of not forgetting that you have things coming. I don't really have anything in these three columns, but here we have the big guns. I wanted more discreet one, like a smaller, like a compact camera, but it's so expensive. I should also put here live stream camera, because I wanted to do live streams, study with me live streams. Wait, the emojis look a lot better than the pictures here. I changed like all the emojis so they match a little bit better. Next we have academia, and this was based on a template, part of a template by Twirling Pages, if I'm not mistaken. I will link the video where she explained like her whole setup, but this is just the academia part of the template, the part that I wanted for mine. I'm going to change this for my class's email and password, because I know my ID number by heart, like I've used it so many times. So this academic plan is just an overview of all the classes. My exam season begins in exactly a month. Can't play the full songs here, I don't think so, which kind of sucks. So this is my soft classical music playlist that I really like. On the right, you have an overview of all the classes. So here's where I put, like, where I check off things. All the lectures. So these, y'all, I have attended these lectures and I do have notes on them, but they're not completed and I wanted to complete them before I check them off, as well as flashcards. So I need to do notes and flashcards for like each one of these. And so I have two things. I have notes and then I have another tag with flashcards. A lecture takes me like a few days to get through. It's really difficult. But yeah, it just makes you a little bit more motivated. I have here all the assignments from the beginning of the semester. She didn't have this, but I just added a very simple widget. It's this one right here. Calendar in line. Next month, I have 4 exams. This month, I have a seminar. So you can kind of check things and kind of stress yourself out and kind of take action. It's really aesthetic to plan here and to check things off here. So that's Notion. I've only started using Anki pretty recently, since April, a few days ago really, because I was starting to think like I really need to make some flashcards and start revising them since exams are coming up. And so because I'm still like in the process of reading lectures and stuff, Anki is definitely a lot more professional. It has add-ons, people that program things that you can use. And so you can see you can change the color of the graph and stuff. Like, it's really cool. Every day I want to have these checked off, but clinical sciences is just questions, random questions from AMBOSS that I do. So many videos explaining much better than I ever will. But it's basically a place where you can do flashcards and it will automatically, based on how good you got the answer, it will automatically change the frequency and the days until you see the card again. But you really do have to show up every day, and I think that's the thing that really put me off Anki, is because I felt so bad because I didn't show up every day and then cards piled up and I really hated memorizing. Right now I just see it as like a game and it's something that I just kind of just do every day. I feel like it will help me a lot in exams. This is where I memorize, get things in my head from my notes. I basically just, everything that I think is important on my notes, I will type fast a flashcard. And yeah, next we have OneNote. Even though that I had privilege to do this, because everything from Microsoft Office is obviously paid, and I didn't know that with my school account I had access to all the programs for Microsoft Office. So now I type my notes here, and I've shown y'all how I do my notes from PowerPoint. So inside the book you can have like sections, and these are the pages inside the sections. I'm so far away from actually finishing all my lectures. I try, like, I just give my best. So I have like 3 notebooks. Each row is a PowerPoint slide. The first column is a title. The second column is the substantial information that they mention. And the third column is things that I think can be asked on a test. And so it would go on a flashcard. And so I just do that for each slide, each lecture, and just go through all the materials. I explain this in more detail on my study tips video. The final thing that I want to show is a Google Calendar. I really like my physical planner, and that's basically where I plan my time. I don't really feel the need to pass every single event on my Google Calendar. What I use the Google Calendar for is to actually communicate with my mom. I normally share events with my mom on Google Calendar because you have the option. Let me try to create like a task here. You have the option to add guests, and you can add in emails, and it will appear on the other person's planner, Google Calendar. And that's basically what I do. Like, I write my name here. This is my middle name, so she knows that's from me. and then the time and where I have to be. This is this week, and you can see that I have two classes this week, like it's so empty. A new way that I found to kind of organize each other, it's helped so much. So yeah, that is it. I think that's what I wanted to show. Hope you found something interesting or something new that you want to implement. This is everything that I do on my computer. I'm definitely going to sleep now. Lit a candle so y'all could have a nice warm color in the background. Ended up not being used. But today I had a hospital morning and then class at like 3 p.m. I'm tired as heck. Fell asleep on my bed by accident like 3 times. I normally just go there and I just rest a little bit, but I'm up like I can't fall asleep throughout the day, but I've been so tired. But I'm really grateful for all the studying and all the work, because I feel like today at the hospital, it really gave me like purpose to know what they were talking about and know what to do with the patient. It really gave me a lot of motivation. So I'm just really grateful and thankful to be in medicine. It makes me really happy, and I'm going to try to do better and know a lot of things. Happy to have you here, listen to me chat about my life. It just means the entire world. I'm going to sleep now. We're signing off. Sending my loves. And who's watching on Patreon, thank you so much. I love you so much. And yeah, see you soon. Bye.